بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم آج ہم اپنا ٹاپک سٹارٹ کر لیتے ہیں وی ہیو ٹو سٹارٹ دا فرمیکیوٹس لو جی پلس سی گرام پازیٹیو بیکٹیریا کلاس بیسیلائی آرڈر لیکٹو بیسیلیلز ان دا آرڈر لیکٹو بیسیلیلز دیر آر تھری میجر فیملیز Enterococcaceae, Streptococcaceae, and Leuconostocaceae. Actually, these are very important family. Today, we will discuss about the family Streptococcaceae. In the family Streptococcaceae, first of all, we are discussing Streptococcus. The genus Streptococcus is large and complex. All species in the genus are facultative, anaerobic, and catalase negative. We have discussed that Staphylococcus aureus is catalase positive, while all the species included in the Streptococcus are all catalase negative. One of the most important abilities to lyse red cells when grown on the blood agar, an agar medium containing 5% sheep or horse blood. The most important property of Streptococcus is that when they are grown on the red blood cells containing 5% sheep or horse blood, actually they lyse them. Now, for this purpose, a scientist named Brown, he classified the Streptococcus into various groups, and this classification is known as Brown classification. This classification was based on the basis of the growth of the Streptococcus on the blood agar. He classified the Streptococcus genera into three groups: alpha hemolytic, beta hemolytic, and alpha hemolytic, beta hemolytic, and non hemolytic, or gamma hemolytic. Alpha hemolytic, what are alpha hemolytic? Those bacteria that do incomplete hemolysis. When they do incomplete hemolysis, usually green zones are appear on the blood agars, and the example of alpha hemolytic bacteria are Streptococcus pneumonia and viridans groups. Viridans groups we will discuss in the last lectures. Streptococcus mutans, Streptococcus s.mitis, and Streptococcus s.sanguis, and Streptococcus pneumonia. Actually, they are alpha hemolytic. They are incomplete hemolysis. They do incomplete hemolysis on blood agar. The next group is actually Streptococcus pneumonia. How you will differentiate between the viridan group in the lab and Streptococcus pneumonia? Streptococcus pneumonia is optochin sensitive and bile soluble. The colonies of the Streptococcus pneumonia are soluble in the bile, while the viridan group, they show resistant to the optochin and their colonies are not soluble in the optochin. On this basis, you can differentiate between Streptococcus pneumonia and viridan group, although both are incomplete hemolysis. They are alpha hemolytic bacteria. The next group in the Streptococcaceae is in the Streptococcus genera is beta hemolytic. Actually, some species are they do complete hemolysis by special type of enzymes called hemolysin. One is called streptolysin O, which is oxygen sensitive, and the other is called streptolysin S. This is oxygen stable. In beta hemolytic group, there are two species, Streptococcus pyogen and Streptococcus agalactiae. These two are beta hemolytic. Actually, Streptococcus agalactiae, they possess streptolysin O, and streptolysin S, they perform beta hemolysis. Now, how you will differentiate these two bacteria, these two species of bacteria, pyogen and agalactiae, although they both are beta hemolytic? So we can say that Streptococcus pyogen is Bacitracin sensitive, while the Streptococcus agalactiae is resistant. And after when you perform your culturing, and after that you observe that you will observe that both the colony complete hemolysis, then you differentiate it into Streptococcus agalactiae or Streptococcus pyogen. Streptococcus pyogen will be Bacitracin. You will treat it Streptococcus pyogen will be Bacitracin sensitive, while the agalactiae, they are resistant. Now, another classification for the Streptococcaceae family, for the Streptococcus genera, another classification, this is called Lenz-Pill group classification. Actually, this Lenz-Pill group classification was proposed by Rebecca Lenz-Pill on the basis of antigen in the cell wall. You know that some Streptococcus, the species of Streptococcus, possess antigen in the cell wall. On the basis of that antigen, we classified the Streptococcus. This classification is not applicable for Streptococcus pneumoniae and viridans group. This is not really applicable, because Streptococcus pneumoniae and Streptococcus viridans do not possess these antigen. There are some species in the viridans group they do possess, but generally the clinical important viridans group bacteria, they do not possess these antigen. So you should note it that Streptococcus pneumoniae and viridans group actually they do not possess Lenz-Pill antigen. According to this classification, the Streptococcus pyogen is called group A, and Streptococcus agalactiae is called group B Streptococcaeae, because they possess the group A and group B antigen respectively. And according to this classification, there are many other bacteria. They are classified as group C, group D. We will discuss in the next chapter. But group 2 Streptococcus, they are given Streptococcus xmilis, Streptococcus equis, Streptococcus zoo epidemicus, etc. We are going to discuss the genera in detail. The first one is Streptococcus pneumoniae. Streptococcus pneumoniae is gram-positive, lancet shaped cocci, arranged in pair. Arranged in pair mean that they are diplococci. Look at this. Okay, when you perform the gram staining, after gram staining, you will observe the Streptococcus pneumoniae in diplococci form. Look at it. These are the Streptococcus pneumoniae. Actually, I have used the term lancet shape. Lancet terms means that the diplococci are oval with somewhat pointed ends, rather than big round. But it means that the colonies are not round, but they are some pointed or somewhat pointed ends. So they are classified as lancet shaped pneumonia. Another important terminology you have learned about, you have heard that Streptococcus pneumoniae is also known as pneumonococcus, and the plural is pneumonococci. Pneumonococci possess a polysaccharide capsule of more than 85 antigenic resistant types. On the basis of the polysaccharide capsules, they have more than 85 different antigenically distinct types. Main property of Streptococcus pneumoniae, you discussed that they are alpha hemolytic, up to chin sensitive, and colony are soluble in the bile. Another important factor that Streptococcus pneumoniae possess ticoic acid and the cell wall called C acceptans. Actually, this is also known as C polysaccharide. It reacts with the normal serum protein made by the liver called CRP, C reactive protein. This C carbohydrate, they react with the CRP. Actually, what are CRP? CRP is not antibody, but it is an active phase protein that is elevated as much as 1,000 times fold in acute inflammation. During acute inflammation, the CRP protein are usually elevated. clinically, CRP play a very important role. It is measured in the laboratory by its reaction with the carbohydrate of Streptococcus pneumoniae. When somebody have elevated CRP, you know there is the chances of a heart attack, and it is very good test as compared to the cholesterol level. CRP is a good test that is usually done in the laboratory for the confirmation of heart attack. Now, the disease caused by the Streptococcus pneumoniae, they are pneumonia, bacteremia, meningitis, infection of upper respiratory tract such as otitis media. Otitis media mean infection of the middle ear, mastoiditis and sinusitis. Pneumococci are most common cause of community acquired pneumonia, meningitis, sepsis, otitis media. We are discussing the genus Streptococcus pyogen. Streptococcus pyogen, according to the Lenz field classification, they are classified as group A. Actually, they are Bacitracin sensitive and beta hemolytic. The important characteristic that possess M protein and capsule composed of hyaluronic acid. And these M protein and capsule are antipegocytic. Actually, they also possess hyaluronidase, that is spreading factor. They in joints and bone there is hyaluronic acid. They actually dissolve this hyaluronic acid and spread in this way. Another important factor in the Streptococcus pyogen is streptokinase. Actually, this is fibrinolysin and antithrombotic. You know that it is sometimes used during the coronary heart attack disease antithrombotic to dissolve the thrombus. Another important toxin produced by Streptococcus pyogen is erythrogenic toxin. It causes the rash of scarlet fever. So you know that scarlet fever is caused by Streptococcus pyogen. Another important factor is streptolysin O. Streptolysin O means that streptolysin O is an enzyme that performs beta hemolysis, and the antibody produced against streptolysin O is ASO titer into streptolysin O antibody. It is used as a diagnostic tool. Another is streptolysin S. Streptolysin S is a hemolysin that is not inactivated by oxygen, so they are oxygen stable. Pyrogenic exotoxin is also produced. It causes toxic shock syndrome. Exotoxin B is also produced by Streptococcus pyogen. It is a protease that rapidly destroys tissue. It also causes immunological disease such as rheumatic fever and acute glomerulonephritis. They are caused in the advanced stage. Now the another group that is viridans, streptococci, they are a large group of commensal streptococcal gram-positive bacteria. Species that are alpha-hemolytic, producing a green coloration on the blood agar plates. Hence the name viridan from Latin viridus mean green. The viridan group are so named viridan because it is from Latin word viridus, which mean green. Some species possess no lincipide antigen, while some species possess. They also lack either the polysaccharide-based capsule that is possess typically of Streptococcus pneumonia. Viridans streptococci have the unique ability to synthesize dextrin from glucose, which allows them to adhere to the fibrin plate aggregate and damage the heart walls. You know that some viridan group are involved in the heart damage into endocarditis. Why? Because they have the ability to synthesize dextrin from glucose, and which allows them to adhere to the fibrin platelets. Streptococcus sanguis group, actually this group of organism can be beta hemolytic, alpha or non-hemolytic. They are different from the pneumococci in that they are optochin resistant or not bile soluble. Streptococcus thermophilus, this is very important. It is also known as Streptococcus salivarius. It is also non-motile. It is also classified as lactic acid bacterium. Streptococcus thermophile is found in fermented milk products and is generally used in the production of yogurt. Yogurt and cheese that contain live cultures of Streptococcus thermophiles are thought to be beneficial to health. The bacteria break down lactose, the sugar in the milk, that lactose intolerant people find difficult to digest. You should give it to the lactose intolerance disease patient. Now, it asks about the different genera of the family Streptococcaceae, order Lactobacillales, and basic class Bacilli, and phylum low G plus C gram positive bacteria. Now, how you will do the hierarchy of taxonomy? The Streptococcaceae family belong to the domain Eubacteria, kingdom Monera, phylum Firmicutes, class Bacilli, order Lactobacillales, or family Streptococcaceae.